arch facade that decorated the doorway of a building in Chelsea came down in large pieces and then landed on the sidewalk. Now the Department of Buildings is investigating. CBS 2's Christina Phan has the details.
You can see dust swirling in front of this West 20th Street building after chunks of the building's facade came crashing down Monday. The deafening roar startling onlookers just feet away.
Literally, it came down in, I want to say, half a second. It was just like boom.
It's awful. And who would expect that in a brownstone?
Nobody was injured, but this collapse was the latest in a series across the city. On December 17th, a woman was killed by a piece of falling debris near Times Square, sparking the Department of Buildings to pass new rules, including more hands-on inspections, increased penalties for owners who fail to make repairs, and a requirement for landlords to post the status of facades in lobbies.
If you look at the infrastructure over there, you can see cracks. Accident. And that's exactly why it broke. And like the weather conditions and everything changing.
But the new rules only apply to buildings over six stories tall. The site of today's collapse is only three. Families want to ask city leaders how these smaller landlords will be held accountable.
A lot of these buildings, they were built in the 1850s, and so you'd have to expect that at some point they're, you know, not going to be structurally, you know, great.
The DOB told us facade inspections for buildings six stories or lower are complaint driven right now. Council member Robert Cornegie told us he agrees more needs to be done.
We may increase the amount of inspections that are necessary over a period of time, but we're not letting anybody off the hook.
We reached out to this building's owner, who declined to comment. The DOB says it is conducting a full investigation and will issue violations if necessary. In Chelsea, Christina Phan, CBS 2 News.
The Department of Buildings adds that it has also doubled the size of its facade inspection team in response to December's fatal collapse.